All right. Well, it's so wonderful to have you all here. So what we'd like to do is ask you the same question, and if you will give your name and the name of your project, and actually what motivated you to create one of these wonderful webisodes and web series. And since you're right here, we'll start with you.
Hey, hi everybody, my name is Curtis Fortier. Mine is a 12-sided die. It was the third one there. Thank you very much. One of my actresses is up there, Kate Torrey. What motivated me is I do play a role-playing game with some friends of mine, and as we get older, it's tougher and tougher to get together. And everybody's having kids, and everybody's, you know, the marriages, and just life is getting in the way, and I wanted to write something about keeping that connection with people that you've known for 20 years before life gets in the way. That's what I wanted to do.
Well, I think you did it.
Thanks.
Was great. And you want to pass it to the fellow behind you?
Hey, everyone. My name is Aaron Wright, and I'm here with my son tonight. We produced the Six Figures No Suits, and we got kissed by the California sun today. And
yeah, you do look a little red there.
But my son and I were planning a trip out here anyway, and we found out that we were nominated. So I started a company called The Construction Channel, and we're trying to encourage young people to get involved in the construction industry. And there are a lot of DIY and, you know, home building, but nothing really on the large scale for construction. So we really want to inspire people to learn about construction, and we feel like we could be the ESPN Netflix for construction someday. So wow. I appreciate everybody watching, and we say watch and build. So thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Craig Phones. I'm with That 80s Guy, writer, producer, and actor. And That 80s Guy came about because I love the 80s. And my co-producer, the brother in the trailer, he loves the 80s too. And we both...
90s aren't bad either. Yes. Or the 20s, or the 60s.
Yeah, and so we put all the 80s music and what we loved about the 80s into the series. And the funny thing about this, we call this the pilot, but it's on Amazon Prime if you want to see the whole series. We call it the first season, but it's really typically just the pilot because it's 5 episodes. And season 2 and 3 are going to be in the lines of Netflix, 22 to 30 minutes, 10 episodes each. And we have 6 actors from the 80s that are coming back, 4 from Valley Girl. So if you like Valley Girl, you'll be able to see them in season 2.
Great, thank you.
I'm Eric Mann. I'm with the Hafiz Project. It was the first one. And if you know Rumi, Hafiz was 100 years after Rumi. And I was reading these poems, and I thought, these need visuals. So we've done 4 now, and a 5th one's coming up. But we filmed during the solar eclipse in 2017, and it was truly breathtaking. So happy to be here.
Good, thank you. Yeah. Go ahead.
My name is Hilary Bosarch. I'm with Out of State, Out of Mind, the fun travel show about weird laws. And that was our pilot sizzle. And we have other episodes ready to go, just not filmed yet. But we get into some serious laws. And then we have the fun ones, as you saw, which we tried to keep this one just fun and entertaining. But yeah, I also do the host, and I was drunk.
That beer can really get to you.
It was only like 4 beers. It was just fun, and it's great to meet with historians and people of different states and see how beautiful it is. I don't know, that's Arizona. It's beautiful. California is as well. I mean, yeah, it's gorgeous, and it was fun.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mary McGloin. I'm creator of Tech Betties. And it's a workplace comedy about women in tech. That was our 3rd episode. We've shot 3. It came about in sort of an interesting way. I've been an actress my whole life, but I've been working in tech as a QA engineer for many, many years. And back in 2014, I was writing a totally different web series about Shakespearean actors and having writer's block. And I had gone to South by Southwest to see the stuff there, and I saw the premiere of Silicon Valley, HBO Silicon Valley. There was a talk back afterward with Mike Judge and all the actors, and I got up and I was like, hi, I'm Marion Gloin. I'm an actress and a QA engineer, and I used to work in Silicon Valley, and I thought it was hilarious, and I have a question for you, and I don't mean it to be challenging, but do you have any plans to have any female characters who are engineers, because we exist? And the audience went nuts, and then the actors started making these jokes about, we're nerds, we don't know how to talk to girls, and Mike Judge was like, yes, I was an engineer, and my ex-wife was an engineer, I just haven't written that yet. So come, like, years later, it still hasn't been done on that show, and I happen to be talking to my friend Amanda Van Nostrand, who helped me write the series, and she was like, why don't you write about your day job in tech, and I'll help you, because I used to work in tech, too, and so their Tech Buddies was born.
It's great motivation, great story, thank you.
Hi, I'm Alexandra Kerr, creator of Confessions of a Gamer's Girlfriend. You saw the trailer, the series is actually on YouTube. And it started because I started dating a guy 7 years ago with a habit I thought he'd grow out of. And now I'm about to be a gamer's wife, so here we are. But yeah, so I thought I was isolated in this incident, met a lot of people, found out I'm not. It's a $1 billion industry, guys, and a lot of people do it. So I learned how to play games myself and got into the world, and I'm fascinated by it. So yeah.
Great, thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Michelle Krizik. I wrote and directed Scenes from a Real Marriage. And the idea for that was writing a bunch of scenes that I felt addressed how sex in marriage is not depicted. And it was my sort of dark comedic approach towards sex scenes, but in a marriage with kids. But the theme of the series is really about two people who feel invisible in their marriage and how they move towards intimacy and connection.
Great. You are broke. You are broke.
Oh, I agree. Yes,
yes, you are.
Got a tumor cancer. Well, this is there. Do you want this?
I'll take it.
Okay, great, great.
I had a bite. Okay, go ahead.
Hi, my name is Emily Ann Scott. I was the creator, writer, actress, slash whatever no one else was doing on set for Represent. I started writing this when I found myself in an audition room going out for the role of Chubby Girl, and all the guys next to me had names. So I thought it would be funny to write something about two actresses who don't have any idea how to make a movie, decide to make a movie, and all the genre stereotypes are flipped around. So there's a guy in his underwear running away from the female killer, and there's a manic pixie dream dude. But it's about the process of them making that movie, having no idea how to make it. So it's very meta, because obviously you have no idea how to make something until you make it. So yeah, I guess that's where that came from.
Great, thank you.
Hi, I'm Olivia Cardo. I wrote and directed One True Loves, which were the first trailer that showed. It came from, I was living with my producer at the time, who's also my close friend and has been with me throughout every ex-boyfriend, like, dramatic crush and heartbreak. And I'm just constantly telling him about him and like, oh my god, like he's not texting me back, or like he is texting me back, but only at night. And the series is ultimately about every single person I ever considered the love of my life. And it starts when I'm 11 years old and follows me to present time. And we cast Maddie Ryan to play a younger version of me, and she's excellent. We've shot 4 episodes so far for our awaiting funding. And you can check them out on onetrueloves.com.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, I'm Chelsea Lloyd.
I'm Jenny Austin.
And we co-produced and starred in Or Die Trying, which was one of the last trailers you saw with the 4 girls. And it's about a stand-up comedian, a journalist, a writer, and an actor. And it's their personal lives kind of F up their careers. and it was inspired by our lives, of course, and also our goal was to make something really relatable to everyone that we knew in LA, and also we wanted really high quality, so we shot 4K an hour's worth of content for under 20K, which we're very proud of, and it was just a great experience. So we have kind of like a mini movie, eight-minute episodes, and we had it directed, produced, written, and starring women. We're committed to female crew, 85% in front and behind the screen. So we're really proud of it, and we're excited for what's to come.
Yes, basically, we just wanted to make a story about women in film, created by women in film. And you can find us on odtseries.com, and on Facebook, all of our eight episodes are there. Thank you.
Okay, well, thank you all so much. All of your projects are so different and so wonderful, and they all had a lot of heart. I know that we all wish you a lot of work and praise and for your next project, whatever that might be. And we all thank you, and good luck to each and every one of you. Thank you.